As a busy day in the Pir Vadhai bus terminal fades into evening, the sound of the equally busy night trade can be heard. These gentle sounds indicate that young boys are ready for their first clients of the night. Under the cover of semi-darkness, other children move about stealthily, collecting scrap metal, used oil, or anything else to recycle. When their sacks are full, they might go home for a few hours of sleep or look for a safe corner to rest until dawn. For others, work just continues. Pir Vadhai, near the bustling city of Rawalpindi, is Pakistan's busiest open-air terminal, with up to 1,200 buses travelling through the terminal each day. Its 9,000 square meters harbour various bus stands, some 2,000 small shops, and about 100 inns and food and tea stall, and much more. From gambling, drug and human trafficking, smuggling, to prostitution, child labor and child abuse, Pir Vadhai is a hub of criminal activity. Built on an old cemetery, residents believe the bus terminal is cursed with many evils.
I didn't know anybody here. I was hungry and had no money, so I asked a hotel owner if he had a job for me. I thought I could wash dishes and make a living for myself. I told him I knew nobody in town, so he let me stay in a room where other children were living.
At 15, Jameel was catapulted into a life of prostitution. There is a lot of money involved in this, but for those men, it means nothing, because it's all easy money from drugs and arms smuggling. They get the boys, keep them for a while, then they can resell them when they get bored. Of course, once the boy has had one or two owners, he will be resold for less and less money. At 15, Amir, pictured right, is already a veteran scrap collector. He has worked these dark and dangerous streets since he arrived in Rawalpindi, leaving his family in the village at age 7. For 7 years he lived in a scrapyard, surviving on bread, tea and boiled potatoes. A poor diet is the least of his concerns, being harassed by drug addicts, beaten by a scrap dealer, and at least twice sexually assaulted by strangers. All come with the territory. On average, a boy like Amir can earn $2 every day collecting materials for recycling. Most of Pir Vadhai's residents are migrants from the impoverished countryside or Afghan refugees. Many are not entitled to any kind of government support. For children, accessing education is problematic, but survival, not education, is the priority for families here.
We have so many problems. We can't be bothered with school. What use do I have for school? There are 11 people in my family. When my father says, bring me to 50 rupees, I have no choice. I must work.
The Manzil Drop-In Center, established by World Vision in 2008, targets children who work in and around Peer Vadhai. Manzil, which means destination or aim in the Urdu language, offers sessions on health and hygiene, classroom learning, counseling, and recreational time. Each activity is designed to give children the tools and opportunities to forge a new future. It's a humble beginning, but for the 350 children engaged at the center and the many more who want to join, it is a beginning. The beginning of a different life. These children are not used to anyone paying attention to their needs or their rights, and that in itself gives them a new perspective on their own self-worth. Many fathers are unemployed, many are drug addicts. There is at least one user in every family, and there is domestic abuse in every household, says World Vision's field coordinator. English teacher Sumaiya Rani, 24, holds her young audience captive as they recite parts of the body. The atmosphere in English and math class is calm and inviting, in contrast to the frenetic pace outside. Manzil offers children a respite, an opportunity to relax, to fear less and trust more. But this sense of structure and calm didn't happen overnight. Children's psychosocial well-being is central to activities in Manzil. Sana Mukhtar, the clinical psychologist, challenges children to express their feelings, think positively about themselves, and witness a different form of behavior.
There is no one they can share their fears, their dreams with. Children want someone they can talk to, someone they can trust. Here, the children don't have to be worried about being beaten. They are free to talk, to share. Here, they are free to be individuals.
At just 7 and 8 years old, Bilkis and Safira are domestic workers that have endured childhood under the shadow of domestic violence. At Manzil, the girls have flourished. They were enrolled in a government school with assistance from World Vision for uniforms and school supplies. There is a huge difference in their behavior since they attended the drop-in center. There were so many problems between their parents, and the children were affected by this, especially Bilkis. Now, you can see, they are very well behaved and happier, shares their aunt, Shahida. And I'm happy because they have learned to read and write, she says proudly. But Aunt Shahida wasn't always a supporter of Manzil. Like many other local families, she was suspicious of what the children were doing at the center. Today, she is one of their biggest supporters and works hard in the local community to encourage parents and guardians to register their children despite their poverty. Encouraging parents to give their children a chance for a different future in the face of such desperate living conditions isn't easy. But more and more local supporters are speaking up to encourage them to do just that. I want these children to get education and give them back their future, says Mohammed Shah, a local scrap dealer and community activist. His thoughts are echoed by the local imam, who also campaigns with Manzil for children's rights to be upheld. Each child enrolled helps to change their world, yet bureaucracy, poverty, and ignorance conspire to prevent children's access to schooling and meaningful employment. Thousands are at risk of spending the rest of their lives trapped in fear and misery.